Released on May 11, 2010, Skate 3 is the last good skateboarding game. The developer studio disbanded following its release, and any word of a sequel is simply hearsay by EA. Ever since, people have yearned for another skateboarding game. To try to meet this demand, indie game studios have attempted to profit off of the impatience of EA Skate fans. SkaterXL, being the most polished of these spiritual successors, has at least somewhat succeeded at that. While the game is not as in-depth as Skate 3, what it does excel at is having fluid movement, decent animations, and with the inclusion of custom maps, creates a sandbox world for fans of the skateboarding genre to play with. It's a lot of fun to just romp around in LA and skate at famous spots. Even the community main maps keep me coming back to the game, as everyone seems to be better than the last. Since release, I've put over 500 hours into SkaterXL, more than any other game in my Steam library, and is probably rounding out the top of my list of my most played games of all time. So the game must be pretty good, right? Well, yeah. No, the game is not very good. As I said, the game is not as in-depth as any of the previous EA Skate games. It doesn't have a story, there's no progression, there's no characters, no achievements, there's no charm. The game is only fun, and I use that term loosely, because skateboarding is fun. So why is this my most played game on Steam? Fully released in July of 2020, SkaterXL came at a time when the world was in a frenzy. Stepping foot outside would literally kill you, so everyone found themselves sitting in front of a screen even more so than usual. As a result, tech stocks boomed and the S&P soared to new heights, and Twitch streamers got paid millions per month to provide viewers with some resemblance of normal social interaction.
What a fucking
YouTube viewership? Up. Netflix subscriptions? Up. Online businesses? Booming. Graphics cards? Fuck you. Home gym equipment? Everyone who bought a Bowflex 8 years ago and used it as a clothes hanger to their wife's disgruntlement finally got the last laugh as they sold it for 3 stimulus checks. And somewhere along the line, a certain gay, meth-smoking zookeeper was the link between worlds to finally get right-winged Facebook users to side with a member of the LGBTQ community. But only because of a conspiracy theory. Video games were getting pushed out in an unreleased state as a way to capitalize on all this newfound free time. And after being in beta for years, SkaterXL finally got the full release treatment, which included a few maps, clothing items, and they threw a few shekels to a couple of real professional skateboarders to get into the game. Other than that, the gameplay is relatively unchanged since the first time I bought it. Yeah, I bought this game back in 2018 when it was in beta and refunded it after 20 minutes because it was essentially a tech demo. And what's changed since then? Just my standards, I guess. The world is still just as empty and soulless, although fitting for an early pandemic game to be totally empty. However, this game has found itself in a unique spot in my catalog. This game has one factor that I haven't found with almost any other game. It's brainless. The game requires zero attention, you barely even have to look at the game while playing it. The only reason I play this game is if I have something else going on my other monitor. It provides just enough stimuli to prevent boredom while doing something else equally boring. It's the elevator music of video games. Nobody has just one monitor anymore. Nobody actually pays attention to YouTube videos. You just slap a video on the second monitor while playing SkaterXL, so you have a constant stream of stimuli to prevent a thought from occurring. Watching a lecture? SkaterXL. Zoom call? SkaterXL. SkaterXL requires such little brain power to play that I actually thought I was getting brain damage due to a lack of neural stimulation. And I don't doubt that if I only played SkaterXL for the rest of my life, I would develop Alzheimer's at the age of 40. With all this said, I don't hate SkaterXL. It's my most played game on Steam, and I still play it regularly. I just hate the fact that I know when EA finally blesses us and Skate 4 falls from the heavens, that I will be unable to play it. Because SkaterXL gave me Alzheimer's. Anyway, now that my 20 minutes of work is up, it's time to relax.
Z.
Narcy.
I can't say it.
She had worked as a stripper. She was considered to be manipulative and unrefined by many people who knew her. Acquaintances of Ben were surprised that he would be interested in somebody like Narcy, but they would later say that Ben appeared to genuinely love and care for her.